times turning all around times, I'm gonna praise the Lord. Dark times, bright times, nothing going right times, I'm gonna praise the Lord. I believe he knows the things I need and he's in control. I was made to give him all the praise, 'cause he is the Lord. Up times, down times, turning all around times, I'm gonna praise the Lord. Dark times, bright times, nothing going right times, I'm gonna praise the Lord. I believe he knows the things I need and he's in control. I was made to give him all the praise, 'cause he is the Lord.
Hello, welcome to Ignite. It's Pete here, and it's great to see you here this morning. As you can see from the tree behind me, we're starting to talk about Christmas today, which is brilliant because I love Christmas. I love the Christmas story. I love the celebration of Jesus, God himself, coming here on earth to show us what it is to be human and to live and to die for us. The only problem with Christmas is having to wait for it to get here. It seems like it's taking forever. I first saw shops starting to sell things for Christmas back in August. That's ages ago. And when you're really looking forward to something, it just seems too long. It just seems like you just can't wait. Do any of you find it really difficult to wait for things that you really, really want? Well, that's partly what the story of Christmas is about. Because for hundreds and thousands of years, people have been waiting for God to come and fix the broken world, to make it right again, to come and save them. And that's what we celebrate at Christmas, Jesus coming to save us. But people had to wait ages and ages and ages. If they're anything like me, they're not very good at waiting for things they want. What's the longest you've ever had to wait for something? Was it difficult? Well, the people who were waiting for Jesus had been waiting for a very, very long time. Take a look at the stories from these characters to give you an idea.
God's story, Anna and Simeon. So part of God's story is about Anna and Simeon, and it goes like this. For hundreds and hundreds of years, God had been promising his family, the Israelites, a rescuer and king. He told them that this rescuer would come as a baby and would be his very own son. People waited a long, long, long time for the Savior to come. Lots waited their whole lives. Well, when Jesus was finally born, there was a man living in Jerusalem named Simeon. He was especially excited for God's promised king because he loved God and followed him with his whole heart. He even got to talk to God through the Holy Spirit. Nowadays, anybody who follows Jesus gets to talk to the Holy Spirit anytime. But before Jesus was born, the Holy Spirit only talked to some people, and Simeon was one of them. Anyway, one of the things the Holy Spirit told Simeon was that the baby king would be born while Simeon was still alive. Since God had been promising the rescuer for hundreds of years, this was a big deal. Simeon would actually get to meet God's rescuer. Just didn't know when. On the night of Jesus' birth, angels appeared to shepherds and announced Jesus' arrival. They excitedly ran out, telling everyone they knew. But remember, there weren't phones or internet back then, so not everyone knew that Jesus had been born, including Simeon. A little while after Jesus' birth, the Holy Spirit told Simeon to go to the temple. He may not have known why, but he obeyed anyway. Good thing he did, because while Simeon was at the temple, Mary and Joseph brought their new baby Jesus to the temple too, to dedicate him to God. As soon as Simeon saw Mary and Joseph with Jesus, he knew who Jesus was. We don't know exactly how he knew, but he did. Simeon took Jesus in his arms and said, "Lord, you are the king over all. Now let me, your servant, go in peace. That is what you promised. With my own eyes, I have seen what you have done to save your people." See, Simeon was getting pretty old, and meeting Jesus was the one thing he wanted in his life. Now that the rescuer was here, he was ready to die in peace. There was someone else in the temple that day, a woman named Anna. For many years, she had stayed at the temple day and night, worshiping God through fasting and prayer and talking to God through the Holy Spirit, like Simeon. The Bible doesn't tell us exactly how long she'd been there, but by this time, she was 84 years old. She knew God well, and like Simeon, she had been waiting for the king God had promised. Sure enough, Anna came by just as Simeon was talking to Mary and Joseph. Immediately, she praised God. The king was finally here, just as God promised. When Simeon and Anna met Jesus, they were overcome with joy. The Bible tells us that faith is being sure of what we hope for. It is being sure of what we do not see. Simeon and Anna were sure that God had promised to send a rescuer. They were sure he was coming. And when they saw Jesus, they were sure the rescuer had arrived. All because they had faith that God keeps his promises. And that's the story of Anna and Simeon.
So hundreds of years before Jesus was born, God had been speaking to lots of different people and telling them all about his great plan to save the world, coming himself to live as a human, to show us what it is to live God's way, and then to die on the cross for the things that we've done wrong, and come back to life again, to beat death, to provide a way to save us, and make it so that we can live with God forever. It's an amazing story, but for hundreds of years, these people had to wait, not knowing when Jesus was going to come, not knowing what it was going to look like and what it was going to be like. Can you imagine the excitement and the anticipation waiting for God to come and save you? The thing is, when Jesus did come, he wasn't exactly what a lot of people were expecting. He wasn't the king they thought he was going to be. He wasn't born in a palace. His parents weren't a king and a queen. But he was the good news, the light of the world that people needed.
Save the world. shepherds came to see the baby, stood by his mother's side. Here lay the Savior inside a manger. Oh, what a glorious night.
Christmas is all about remembering and celebrating the birth of Jesus, God come to earth to save us and to provide a way that we can be with him forever. It's amazing news and it deserves celebrating. And I'm really looking forward to celebrating that when we get to Christmas this year. But in the meantime, I can get excited about the waiting. I can think about all the amazing things I know about Jesus and what he did and who he was and how much he loved me. And as we wait for Christmas, we can think about those things and get even more excited about the celebration of him coming to save us. For our game today, because we're talking about waiting, we thought we'd play some Sleeping Lions. You might remember when we played this before, but if you don't know how, it's really easy. You find a comfortable space on the floor somewhere and you lie there very, very still. One person will then go round and try and watch for movement. If they see you move at all, you're out. And the last person to be caught moving is the winner. The person going round is not allowed to touch you, but they are allowed to talk to you. See how long you can last. Have fun! Lots of the people that God spoke to before Jesus came were called prophets. They were people who heard from God, and then it was their job to tell the rest of the people what God had been saying. And God had been saying for a long time about his plan to save the world, that he was going to come to sort the mess as a great king. Isaiah, one of these prophets, says this: "For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulders, and his name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace." God gave these words to Isaiah hundreds of years before Jesus was born. And people had this great news for such a long time. When you got great news like this, it's worth remembering. And the people back then would do that by writing it down on scrolls. We've got a craft for you here to make a Christmas tree decoration that's a bit like a scroll, with those words from Isaiah written on it. Take a look at this video and see the one that I made. Then have a go for yourself.
There's magic in the air this evening, magic in the air. The world is at her best, you know, when people love and care. The promise of excitement is one the night will keep. After all, there's only one more sleep till Christmas. Thing is strangers when a stranger says hello, and everyone is family. We're having so much fun. After all, there's only one more sleep till Christmas. 'Tis the season to be jolly and joyous. With a burst of pleasure we feel it arrive. It's a season when the saints can employ us to spread the news about peace and to keep love alive.
We're going to finish Ignite this week with a prayer. If you want it to be your prayer too, just say Amen after me. Father God, thank you so much that you did come to earth to save us, that you came down as a little baby, born into a manger, to live a life that people could look at and see how to live God's way, to die on a cross for us and then come back to life to save us from our sins so that we could be with you forever. Father, help us to understand more about the story of Jesus coming at Christmas. Help us to celebrate his birth at this time of year. Amen. Next week on Ignite is going to be a bit different. We're going to have a special extended Ignite. At church on the 20th at the 9:30 service, Ali and I will be running an Ignite family service called Light of the World. And if you get your tickets, you're welcome to be there and join us. If you can't be with us for that, we're going to put the whole service online. So there will be a 45-minute Ignite next week, followed by the sermon from the normal church service. After next week, we're taking a couple of weeks off Ignite Online over the Christmas holidays, but we'll be back in January with more sessions for you. We hope to see you at the family service if you can, but if not, we'll see you after Christmas. Bye!